Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for coming tonight. I think most of you know why you're here, so we don't need to luosuo, as they say in Chinese. We don't need to add any extra any extra gumph. Delighted to see all of you here for two more of Tsai Ming-Liang's films, No Form and Skywalker. No Form and Where Has the Skywalk Gone, in the opposite order. As with last night, I'll be talking to Tsai Ming-Liang for about 15 minutes before the films begin. Then we're going to show you the films, and then we're going to have a Q&A. And while the Q&A is scheduled for half an hour, there is the possibility of extending it a bit tonight if there's a lot of questions. So, you know, save them up and hit us with them afterwards. I will be doing interpreting as well. So pleased to be here again. My first question tonight is about something that you once said, which is that slowness is a type of rebellion. I'd like you to discuss this with relation to the films we're about to see.
是，我一直觉得我是一个很叛逆的人。
I've always felt that I was a rebel.
但是不是那种去很凶狠的叛逆。
But not like a violent, you know, cruel, wild rebel.
我想我这辈子唯一怕的人就是我老爸，不过他走了。
I've always been afraid of my dad. He's gone now.
So, 而且他走的时候刚好是我拍第一部电影的时候。
He died when I was making my first film.
所以他没有很生气吧？后来。So
he didn't have to get too angry.
我其实不自己不是一个快的人。
Myself, I'm not somebody who's slow. I don't move slowly. I'm actually quite quick.
我跟我妈妈一样走得非常快走路。And
when I walk, I'm like my mother. I just walk really, really fast.
我曾经跟我妈妈在香港旅行。Once
I was with my mother, we took a trip to Hong Kong.
她走在人非常多的地方的时候。
We were in the really crowded place in Hong Kong, and my mother was just racing ahead, and I was sort of back there with my dad. And I saw her do something.
有一个非常老的老太太挡到她，她把她推开了。In
front of her was this old lady who was blocking her way, so she just kind of pushed her aside.
这是我妈妈，我觉得我比较像我妈妈，很多个性很急。My
character is in many ways like that of my mom.
但是我的父亲是很慢的。But
my dad, by contrast, is very slow. Was very slow.
我对我父亲很好奇。I
was always very curious about my father. He made me very curious.
其实我来不及研究他，他就走了。And
I really didn't have a chance to study him, to figure him out, and then he was gone.
后来我遇到李康生，我发现他很像我老爸，所以我就一直看他。And
then later, when I encountered the Li Kangsheng, who became the actor in all of his films, I felt that he was like my father in many ways, so I wanted to understand him.
Yeah, 他很慢，他，He's
very slow.
我们都说慢半拍，他可能是慢了三拍。
He's, oh God, how do you translate that one? He's he's very, very slow.
我记得我第一次拍他的电视片的时候。
When I first made a TV show with him.
街上找到他，觉得他的外形，有一种吸引我的地方，其实就是我老爸的特质，我就请他来演。When
I saw him on the street, there were things that attracted me, and among this was some sort of resemblance to my father.
Yeah, 反应很慢, 转头也很慢, 讲话也很慢。
he's not scared of the camera. In some ways you could say he's very natural in front of the camera, but there are other ways in which he's really not natural. He walks really, really slowly. He turns his head really, really slowly. He talks really, really slowly.
有一个镜头我要他转头。
There was a scene in which I wanted him to turn his head.
应该NG了他大概有十几次，就一直说不行，重来，不行，太慢了，太快一点。后来我觉得他是一个机器人的感觉。我说，那你能不能转头同时眨一个眼睛？那我觉得你是活的。I
had to do this, you know, like this particular take maybe 10 times. I felt like he was like this robot or something. He was like a machine. And I said to him, can you at least blink in the course of turning your head? Because then we'll know that you're a person, that you're alive.
他也有点气，他就忽然间回了我一句话。他说我就是这样子，这是我的自然。
He said, he was a little bit angry with me. And he said to me, he said, you know, this is how I am, naturally.
我觉得他这句话 改变了我对表演对很多东西的看法。And
that what he said to me that day changed really my views on performance and on making films.
我开始对慢有兴趣，应该是李康生。And
that really made me interested in slowness. It was from 李康生。我觉得不是要慢，不是故意要慢，是要找回自然，and
it was 每一个人的自然。
It's not a thing about looking for slowness in particular. It's about trying to return to a sense of naturalness.
We 可是如果你跟一个专业演员在私底下吃饭或者喝茶聊天，他有一种你没有看过的样子出现在你的眼前。It's
really hard to get naturalness in film because people are taught not to be natural. There are certain ways that people are taught to act and so on. And that it applies to pace. It applies to speed, it applies to tempo, it applies to speed, it applies to a number of things. And it's funny because you'll have the way an actor is in front of the camera, and then you'll maybe be having a cup of tea or eating with them, and you notice that the person in front of you is very, very natural and is not the person who was in front of the camera.
Yeah, 可是我特别喜欢那种样子。
But I really, really like that. I don't like the other.
所以我每次碰到这些演员，我都很想把他平常的样子找回来。So
whenever I'm with an actor, what I want to find or what I want them to return to is that genuine, natural self.
其实我已经离题了，我已经不知道讲到哪里去了。And
I don't really know where I've gone with that question.
简单说，我为什么慢，越来越慢哈？哦，不是。
慢就是一种叛逆。叛逆，对，后来也不是叛逆了。So you know, slowness is a kind of rebellion, but in the end, it really wasn't a rebellion at all.
它是很自然，因为我年纪大了，我也快不起来了。我觉得非常好，这个速度。I
myself have become slower. I'm older, and I, you know, I'm used to this now. This slower pace.
当然。 如果要讲，真正的要讲，为什么慢，可以讲很多，简单说，你只有慢的时候才看得到。
I could talk about a lot of reasons for slowness, but I'll just say that it's when you are being slow that you actually see things.
特别是电影，我们都以为我们在看一个故事。
With film, we think we're watching a story.
不需要速度, 我们需要的是剧情, 答安排。
So we think we're not thinking about speed, but we're thinking about the details of the plot.
所以很少在电影里面看到时间这个概念。
So it's rare to see, to really feel the sense of time in a film, or to feel time in a film.
或者看清楚一个动作,
or to see a movement clearly.
或者一个行为,
or a behavior. Because the 2-hour time frame means that the story has to keep pushing forward. So you don't see these things
as they
And with yesterday's stray dogs, it's because it's slow, so we can see what they're doing. I wanted to...
时间差不多了。
No, I want to ask another question.
Okay.
He said, is the time to... I said, no, I have another question. And this question applies to, in particular, the Skywalk film. And that is, you've talked about the importance of disappearance and the erotics of disappearance, how disappearance is very important to you as a theme. Would you mind talking a little bit about that?
消失不见啊，那个道理跟慢是一样的。
It's a similar principle to slowness.
就像我爸爸。
And it's like his father.
他在的时候，我常觉得他不在。
When he was there, I always felt I felt his absence.
Yeah, 他不在的时候，我突然间觉得他在了。
But when he left, I really felt his presence.
想他。
And I began to miss him and think of him.
所以我自己对很多对我有约束的东西我都很怀疑，包括我的父亲，包括父权，包括家庭，好，包括很多价值观，我都觉得很约束我。可是我要处理，我想面对这些事情的时候，这些问题的时候，透过创作的时候，我通常采取一种方法，让它消失掉。
I'm not comfortable with things that constrain me, whether it's patriarchy, the idea of family, of a father's, father's authority, all this sort of thing. Oh, yeah. And so what I do to my reaction to this is to make them disappear. This is my method.
Yeah, 可以看到它，比如说家庭，所以我整个电影的创作过程里面，好像对每一个议题都是采取破坏的方式，比如说爱情，就是没有爱情，我们才说爱情万岁。So
everything that everything that I want to look at, I kind of destroy. I get rid of it. So, for example, in Viva l'amour, the love, you destroy the love, and then you can talk about Viva l'amour.
所以但是我觉得这个世界也是这样子的，就是说，比如说天桥不见了，他是我拍这个电影之前拍了一个电影叫《你那边几点》，就有一个场景是在那个天桥上，李康生卖手表给陈香琪，可是真的拍完之后的三个月，我经过那个车站，他已经不见了，他让我非常震惊，有一种很荒谬的感觉，有一种失落感。
The direct inspiration for the Skywalk is gone came from when I was filming a scene in What Time Is It, which is another film. And in that scene, Li Kangsheng is selling watches on this overpass, and or Skywalk in Chinese, it's a Tianqiao. It's like Sky Bridge. Anyway. He's selling watches on this thing. So they filmed that, they were filming on this place all the time. And then 3 months afterwards, I happened to be walking past this place and I looked up and it was like, wow, this Skywalk is gone. it was gone. And so it just made everything feel really surreal and kind of absurd and like a dream. And so that's where the inspiration for this came. And
I 消失的状态，我觉得不是我才有感觉的，我猜非常多人有感觉，因为那个桥，可能是台北人或者来台北经过的人都很熟悉的桥，每天都要走的桥，有一天忽然间就不见了，我的确有遇到一些人。 在广播的时候跟我讲说，他们不会走路了，不会过马路了，啊，就没有方向感了，因为你开始要走一个新的途径，在地下道那个地下走道去找新的路，所以我想说，我们好像一直在追赶这种变化，其实是很焦虑的。
I wanted to film the anxiety that you feel when things disappear. It wasn't just me who missed that particular skywalk or skywalks that are destroyed in Taipei. After I got all these messages from people who were saying, I don't even know how to find any place anymore. I can't cross the street. There's no skywalk. You have to go under these underpasses and you have to find these new routes. It's just really disorienting. So it creates a sort of anxiety. We keep having to catch up with disappearances. And I wanted to film that sense of anxiousness.
So 比如说，我觉得这个世界跑得太快的时候，我们其实很少能够认真的看我们生活的地方，很少认真看我们的生活，或者认真看我们每天经过的地方。所以我就想拍一个更慢的电影，因为我自己想看，不久它会消失掉。I
feel like this thing that keeps running through my films, and that is this sense of not seeing what's around us, and what I want to do is capture this. And by making these films, which are slower and slower as I go along, I feel like I am able to look at what I want to see. And I think with that, we can watch the films and then return to a Q&A. So thank you so much.
影片很短。 所以应该不会睡着吧。
And today, unlike yesterday when Tsai Ming-Lang gave a warning, there's very little danger of you sleeping during the films today because they are very short.
人没有昨天多，因为都是被吓到了。
Today we don't have quite as many people as yesterday. Yesterday it was absolutely packed because so many people from yesterday are probably too scared to come and see another film. That one gets better with every viewing. You're kind. Yeah. I'm going to start with my question, and then that's because I'm sitting here. It's like last night was like, why do you do this? Because I'm the director. So why do I get to ask the first question? Because I'm sitting here. 我说昨天说为什么？对，我是导演。我说为什么能够问第一个问题？是因为我是导演。So my first question is, yesterday we talked about Yue Fei and Man Jiang Hong, and we talked about Lao Zi and Tian Di Bu Ren. I'd just like you to say a few words about Xuanzang, the monk in the monk who goes to India across the Silk Road and brings back the scriptures, because I know that you've talked about him a little bit before. I like Xuanzang.
非常喜欢.
I like him a lot.
读到他的时候，不是《西游记》的玄奘，是真的历史上那个记载的玄奘。读到他的文章的时候，读到关于他的描述的时候，每一次都会很感动。
I really love reading about him, and it's not just from the popular fiction of Journey to the West, which people know as Monkey, but it's from the historical records. Every time I've read anything about him, I've been really moved.
Yeah, 我记得在很多年前有一个电视主持人做了我一个访问的节目。
Many years ago, I was interviewed for a television show. It was about me.
他就例行公事的，要我在最后的时候写一个我的愿望。
And at the very end, asked me to 写。 asked me to write on a piece of paper my hopes or my dreams or my wishes. And I was really surprised, like I actually didn't have anything that I wanted to write down. And I thought, well, actually, I don't want to have any particular desire.
Yeah. 但是他说你一定要写，因为每个人都写了。
But they said, well, you have to, because everybody who comes on the show writes down their desire, what they want.
我就写说，我想拍玄奘。
So what I wrote was, I would like to make a film about Xuanzang.
Yeah, 但是我知道这是不会发生的，因为我不想拍一个故事。
But I knew that, you know, I wouldn't actually make a film about Xuanzang because I didn't want to make a story film, a narrative.
对，我不觉得每个东西都要拍出来，我说，那我随便写一个。So
I was writing that just, you know, to write something, yeah. But it's not like you have to actually film everything.
Yeah, 我特别喜欢他，可能因为。 他有一些精神特别感动我，就是走路的那个精神。I
really like him because there's a lot about him that really moves me, and one of those things is his spirit and his spirit of, you know, how he is walking spirit.
当然那个时代是走路的时代。And
of course that was the age of walking.
Yeah, 问题是你要走到那么远一个不确定的地方去做一件事情，很少人能够做到，或者像他这样有这种。
It's not everyone who has the ability, the spiritual ability, and the mental strength, I suppose, to make such a long journey along an uncertain path to a place that you're not really sure about.
后来在2011年的时候，三年前，对我们的国家剧院找我做一个舞台剧。 刚好我有空我就做了，因为我本来是学戏剧的。
And in 2011, the National Theatre asked me to do a stage play. And so I said, okay, because actually when I was in university, I did, that's what I studied. I studied drama theatre.
他们给我一个题目是独角戏。
独角戏, and they gave me a topic, and it was monologue. Was monologue?
独角戏就一个角色的。
Yeah, like a one person play.
对，随便做什么都可以，就要一个。
So I could do anything I wanted, so long it was a single person play.
我就很贪心，做了三个，因为我有很多很爱的演员，不太有机会再合作。我说找杨贵妹。So
I decided.
陈香琪，陆毅静、李康生。本来要做四个的，还有陈香琪，但他没有空，我做了三个。
三个独角戏。 So what I did is, because there were actually four actors, but I narrowed it down to three actors who I really, really like to work with, so I did three single person plays, and that one was with Li Xiaokang, another one was with
Li Kangsheng. Li Xiaokang也可以.
Li Kangsheng. And another one was...
陈香琪,刚刚那个女生。
And 陈香琪
was... No, 后来演的是陆毅静。
陆毅静, yeah, the one from yesterday.
杨贵妹,
and Yang Guimei.
今天有朋友说他看过那三个戏。
Oh, there is somebody here who actually saw those three plays.
Yeah, 那三个独角戏到底要做什么？其实我就跟我的演员讲说，我们不要演什么有名的角色，我们都演自己好了。
So I said to the actors, well, what are we going to do? Let's not perform some famous person's story or anything like that. I want you all to play yourselves.
Yeah, 所以李康生那个戏比较特别，他演他自己，也演我的爸爸。
So Li Kangsheng, his was pretty special. He played himself and he played my father.
也演玄奘。
Oh, and he played Xuanzang, the monk.
我说这三个男人是我最重要的男人。And
those three men are the most important men in my life.
所以他一个人要演那个戏。所以我们在排戏的时候，有一场戏，有一个排练的时候，有一个画面是李康生要从这个位置走到那个位置，就是他自己走到那个位置的时候变成我的爸爸。
So one of the things that we did was he walked across the stage from that there to there, and in the process went from being Li Kangsheng to becoming my father.
我说你要变成我爸爸要非常困难，不能太容易。
I said to him, you know, it's not that easy for you to become my father. It's not going to be easy.
怎么样移动到那边变成我爸爸，是我们一直思考，自我一直思考的问题，要很难的感觉。
So I felt, well, we want to have a, this is really something that's difficult, and we want to express this. And so how exactly does he transform himself?
舞蹈的方式，请舞蹈老师来设计各种动作，就是让他放一些音乐。可是我都不满意，他也不满意。
We invited a choreographer who came up with some dance-related moves, and we had music and tried that, but neither Li Kangsheng or I were satisfied.
有一天，我们甚至很不开心，吵架。 因为意见不同，跟李康生，对，他说不演了。
So one day, you know, it was just a mess, and we had this fight, and Li Kangsheng and I had the fight, and he said, "Okay, I'm not doing this."
但是后来他又说，我用我的方法，我想很慢的走。And
then he said, "You know, I'll use my method. I'm going to walk really, really slowly."
然后我说好啊，来啊。So
I said, "Okay, try."
开始走，他从这边走到那边。 他走了17分钟
So the length of the stage, it took him 17 minutes to traverse that stage.
其实我是很震动，非常感动。
And I was really, really moved by it.
我当时我记得我跟他讲一句话，我说我等了你20年，就在等这次这一刻。
I said, you know, I've been waiting for 10 years for those 17 minutes.
然后这个舞台剧演的时候，他每一次 都要走25分钟到半小时。
And so in the end, when we actually were on stage, he would go, it would take him 25 to 30 minutes.
Yeah, 没有特别的灯光，没有音乐。
And there was no special lighting, and there was no music.
Yeah, 什么都没有，就走路。我觉得观众比较可怜啊。
I felt sorry for the audience.
Yeah, 也很了不起。
But they were really amazing.
我一直觉得我们的剧场一直在讲故事，所以我们好像什么都没有看到，即使是走路我们都没有看到。我就想做这些事情。You
know, I feel like on the stage there's always these stories, these narratives that are unfolding, and people don't see, they don't look at anything in particular, and this actually gave them something to look at.
因为李康生有一种奇怪的身体。
He has a really strange body.
他的脖子不太好。
His neck isn't very good.
所以他有一种姿势，可能是别人没有的，有一种特别的姿势。
He was injured. Well, he has a bad neck, and so there's a certain thing that he does with his neck that other people can't really do quite as well. It's very special.
然后我就说，这个舞台剧演完，招生牧师就没有了，不会，除了那1000个观众，不会有人看到他这么美漂亮的走路的方法。
And you know, there were like maybe 1,000 people who saw this, and that was it. That's that whole thing, that experience was that performance.
然后我就跟他说，哎，我们来拍走路的电影。
And then I said to him, you know, let's make a film with you walking.
如果有资金，我就拍走路，我不要拍剧情片了。那时候。
And I didn't want to do a narrative. I just wanted to do this thing.
然后很奇怪，我认为他好像在做玄奘做的事情。 当时做的事情就是往一个方向一直走去。And
so I felt
he 很像一个玄奘的精神。So
I felt that he really had captured the spirit of Xuanzang the monk.
用一个很慢的速度，跟这个世界的药的速度是不一样的。And
that slowness is something that doesn't match the speed that's demanded in society.
所以我觉得它是一种反叛的概念。
So that's why I call slowness a kind of an act of rebellion.
很奇怪，我当我这样想的时候，资金就来了，不知道为什么就来了，我就拍了第一个是这个。它其实是一个手机的广告，在网络上的广告。对，是手机，但是大陆卖的手机，是一个台商给我钱拍的。
So he made this, and this was actually an advertisement for a mobile phone.
Yeah, 我第二个影片是香港的电影节邀我拍，
and
我也让小康去香港走。
And then the second film of him walking you know, in those robes, was made in Hong Kong at the, it was a commission from the Hong Kong Film Festival.
我记得, 在香港那支, 因为它是优酷大陆的一个网站,
对，出钱的,
所以他们, 这个香港演完之后, 它就在优酷, 在网站上播。
Oh, and the second one, the one that was made in Hong Kong, it was actually sponsored by UQ, which is the mainland version of YouTube. Yeah. And so there is, you can see that on UQ, which is, if you're interested, Y-O-U-K-U, if you don't know it.
You can see that.
Wow. And within 1 month, 400万, there were 4 million people who clicked on it.
应该是我最多人看的电影啊。
That's right. It's probably the most, the biggest number of people who've ever watched one of my films.
但是, 出现一个很有趣的现象是, 有非常大, 大量的人上来骂我。
And then, you know, so many people who just, you know, they would leave comments that were really, really like, you know, they were really rude and they really hated the film.
有人说如果李康生在我的面前经过，我要用一个砖头打他的头。
Somebody said, if Li Kangsheng ever appeared in front of me, I would hit him on the head with a brick.
说这不是一个电影，不是什么，讲了很多。
People would say, this isn't a film.
可是我那个月非常兴奋。
And I felt, you know, all these curses and all this unhappy, you know, these complaints that were coming my way made me quite happy. I felt, there's not that many movies that can really inspire collective anger like that.
我走得很慢，爱找你了。我走得很慢，爱找你了，你知道吗？就关你什么事这样。你为什么要生气呢？你可以不要。I never
answered them, but what I would have said, which I was thinking, was, so I go slowly, and what's this stopping you from doing? what's your problem?
所以你可以看想象到说，做这个事是那么让人家不舒服的事情。
And so you can see from the reaction. That slowness is something that really is an incitement. People, you know, they see a film and it doesn't have expression, it doesn't have a story, and they get really unhappy. But I really want to continue doing this.
我的计划是, 本来计划要在五年、十年, 拍十部, 这样的作品, 而且我希望是在美术馆, 放, 比较不被市场限制, 但是很奇怪, 我两年, 我拍了六部了。
Originally, I thought maybe 5-10 years, I can make 10 of these, and they would, you know, to show them in art gallery, art museums, basically. But then, you know, 2 years, I've already made 6, so there you go.
我的第六部是法国, 马赛的, 艺术节, 请我拍的。 叫西游，你看了哈，是比较长的一部。
There's a relatively long one that I made in Marseille, which is
多长？56分钟。
It's 56 minutes.
也没有事情发生，就走路。
And nothing happens. It's just the same thing.
但是很奇怪，西方的媒体或者评论哈，特别喜欢这个电影。
But strangely enough, Western critics and media seem to like it.
我这个月会在日本拍第七个。
This month, I'm actually going to Japan to do another one.
一样是香港电影节请我拍的。
And this one is also one that it was commissioned by the Hong Kong. One that was commissioned by the Hong Kong Film Festival.
但是我想去日本拍。
So I'm going to go to Japan and do that.
我讲很多。
No, that's great. It's so I just got 17-minute answer, which is the exact amount of time that it took. 我就是讲了17分钟，跟李康生那一次走的一样。啊，真的吗？这个时候。Okay.
我还可以讲更长一点。
He could speak longer, but I think we should ask what questions do you have? Okay, the lady in the back. Okay.
Oh, sorry. Is your intent to make the audience make us feel uncomfortable?
是不是故意让观众不舒服？没有。No.
But the audience isn't in my heart. That's not what I'm thinking
about.
I'm just being a creator. I'm expressing myself.
我没有想过要特别为谁做一个作品。I've
never really thought, you know.
我想就是为我自己做。Who
am I making this for? I'm making it for myself.
没有故意要让谁不舒服，但是为什么你会不舒服？ 这是一个问题。
Yeah, I don't set out to make people uncomfortable, but if people are uncomfortable, then it's an interesting question.
而且有很多状态是你不舒服，你就不允许这个事情发生，这是很奇怪的。
And there's a really strange attitude, which is if something makes you uncomfortable, you don't want that thing to.
可是你很多行为，我可能也不舒服。如果你电影拍得很快，我也可能也不舒服。
But there are things that make me really uncomfortable, like a movie that, you know, is too fast-paced. I'm really uncomfortable.
Yeah, 但是我知道它会引起不舒服，这是我知道。
But I do know and I recognize that this can make people very uncomfortable.
我们必须要面对现实，我很面对现实。我知道我的这样的电影不会让大家很快乐，所以不会太多人看。
I you know, I'm quite realistic. I know that people will feel uncomfortable and that I won't have a huge audience for this sort of thing.
但是我的开心，就在于说我还有权利做这个事情。But
I'm really happy that I've got the ability, the right to do this.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
你会不舒服吗？
Are you uncomfortable? 他说是一种。
那有没有人觉得很享受的？
Did anybody feel that it was a kind of an enjoyment, the opposite of uncomfortable?
所以他们可以讨论一下。I
think, you know, half and half, I was just looking.
Yes.
Wait, can I just say there was a person over here with a, then we'll get the mic to you after. Somebody here, raise their hand first. Then I'll come to you.
Sorry. 蔡导演，谢谢。我想问你就是 你谈起这时间观念感，就我回忆到就是当代作家丰子恺他的一篇散文就《箭》，就三点水，就慢慢的就《箭》字。对对对。那对你来说，你有什么书或者作家，你看了就是你常看会给你带来什么激发感吗？
Can I translate that? Sure. So I've been reading Feng Zakai, who's an author, if you don't know him, from the 30s, who has an essay called Jian, which is sort of gradual or slow, or you know, it has that same sense. So what I was wondering, are there any writers, for example, who give you inspiration in this sort of area?
我也看丰子恺。
I also read Feng Zakai.
我喜欢丰子恺，喜欢他描写一些生活的细节。 比如说怎么吃螃蟹了，特别有印象。He's
really great in describing these like little details of life. For example, eating crabs.
我最多重复看的小说家，中国的啊，是张爱玲。The
person who I probably have read and reread the most is Zhang Ailing.
我想他的作品也是因为基于生活嘛。And
it really is about it's rooted in life.
她最好的小说都在上海的时候写完了。And
her best ones were written while she was still in Shanghai.
我想说，在上海她可以很热情的生活，后来就不太能，不知道为什么，就为了生活而生活。我想，所以有时候很觉得，有时候一个时代可以决定一个作家的命运。Sometimes
an era can determine the fate of a person. It's about, you know, living for the sake of living. And I should add, I have two scrolls of Feng Zakai's, I mean, prints in my study, because I love him too. Does that answer your question? Okay.
Hello.
I think it's okay. I'm loud enough, you know, I don't need it.
But the people in the back, the people.
Okay, yeah, I can see. Actually,
can you hear him?
Yeah, okay. I think so. Oh, people get my voice. Yeah, I'm loud enough. say what's my understanding of speed is called rhythm of life, you know? Quite a few years ago, one of my friends and me, we did the same experiments in a small office in Beijing, but the art we use is music, not movie. We tried to play some spiritual music, some Buddhism, some Hinduism, some from Sufi Islamic music. Of course, it's not only focused religion, but people feel noisy, you know? If you play hip-hop, some fast rhythm, they're really happy. But actually, they're tired for life. They live in the blocks, you know? They live in corporate forests. But we need to ask questions why people lost slowness. It's the reason of, you know, globalization and industrialization, like Zapata. The Marx said, it's like a wall, block people's idea. You can only see fast. The slowness was blocked in corner, you never see. But the second reason is like, the reason life changed. How fast they wheel. Many people in Paris, living in Taipei, they spend 2 hours shuttle, you know, 2 hours shuttle to go to work, 4 hours. You see, our life was filled with speed, and you can really be calmed down. So the problem is like, slowness. No, I try to explain. Slowness become this kind of thing, become uncertain. People don't know what happened for next, so they feel a little bit scared. Anyway.
Do you have a question?
No, not a question. Just okay, my comments.
Okay, you have to translate yourself then.
因为我觉得这个就是说速度这个东西对吧，它其实是一种抽象好上瘾号的一个东西，因为我们生活的轨迹，生命的速度发生了变化，很多年以前差不多五六年前我在北京，我当时上班在CBD做了一个小的试验，就我们放一些音乐嘛，跟主流的音乐不一样，比如有什么斯里伊斯兰的音乐，有印度教，有很多，但是不仅仅是宗教，它特别慢，你在网络上更容易找到，但是很多同事听了特别烦躁。 他说你能不能关掉这音乐？如果放在大词里之后，它很烦躁。但是你如果放一些很快的音乐，但是它会很容易激起。但是你可以反问一个问题：为什么这些很快的，相对说，因为它的生活每天可能坐地铁两小时，下班两小时？如果我们听100年前的音乐到现在的每个时代，它音乐的发展跟电影发展跟时代是相关的，速度越来越快。所以这快它像一堵墙一样，像全球化。 它把我们对于审美、对于艺术电影很多的这种一个concept阻挡住了，这个慢呢，它只躲在角落里面，很多人他看不到的。所以慢呢，传递一种信号或者符号，就是一种他未知，他不知道下一分钟要发生什么。如果这儿走10分钟，走了2分钟之后，他不知道下一分钟要发生什么，所以他失去了耐心。在速度很快的时代，所以慢的话，在很大程度上，它所谓很多人失去了，他会比较焦虑。
或者带来潜在的压抑，都有这种。那我也可以发表一下。也可以发表。很简单了，我想说，我的作品，从来不觉得慢是唯一，可以解决事情的方式。
I've never felt that slowness actually solves the problems. And sometimes it makes me annoyed even.
Yeah, 比如说我去买个高铁的票，那个小姐服务非常好，但她很慢。我就觉得，可是那个火车不会等我们。所以我早来，我还是觉得怎么会那么慢？ 你知道我意思吗？就是一个效率的问题，快慢跟效率有时候没有什么关系。So
you know, and it doesn't fast speed and slowness don't necessarily have anything to do with efficiency. For example, sometimes like I'll go to buy a ticket on an express train, and the person, the girl's behind the counter, her attitude is really lovely. She's incredibly polite. She's very, very nice, but she's really slow. And I'm thinking the train's not going to wait. I need my ticket. So it doesn't necessarily relate, correspond necessarily to efficiency.
我觉得只是想让大家思考一个问题，说，我们有必要这么快的发展。
But I want people to think about the question, do we really need to develop and to move so fast? That's the question I want to ask.
前几天我有一个朋友在微信上跟我分享说他去杜拜多么快乐，因为我们台北的101是个小儿科了，他的帆船旅馆多么厉害，多么好漂亮，多么好玩。刚刚好我也去过杜拜，我很想回他，但是我没有回他。 我不想让他少他的信。您说。
I have this friend who got in touch with me on WeChat and said, oh, in Dubai, and it's so amazing, and this and this and this. And I've been to Dubai as well, but I kind of wanted to say something, but I didn't want to, you know, burst their bubble with their happiness about Dubai.
我觉得101对我来说都是多余的。您多去杜拜多盖几个高楼吧。
You know, I was like, well, you know, okay.
让杜拜变成唯一最高的城市，我觉得没有关系，但是我们生活的地方是可以。
You know, this person was so impressed with these buildings and these tall buildings and everything. I'm like, well, we don't actually need all this stuff. We can actually still be happy
without it. 对，我只想用这个慢走很长的一个速度，李康尊永远不变的速度，看每个地方不同的速度，发现每个地方的速度都不一样。好，可是快速慢速都是比较出来的，但是有一个东西是一样的。
想要快的心是一样的，就说那个慢步是，对，每个城市都不一样，速度不一样，可是心里面都一样的，就快一点，快一点。对对对对对。So you know the speed is different in every city, but there's always this feeling of like, you know, anxiety, got to go faster that surrounds that slowness.
所以我拍这样的。And
so that's why I make these films. We have many more questions. Sorry, first. So please, no more statements if you don't mind. Questions, thank you. But it was an interesting statement.
I want to thank you again for those two films, which were absolutely stunning. Thank you very much. I'm thinking about other slow movie makers. I'm wondering. I mean, movie makers like Belata, Nuri Bilge Ceylan from Turkey, perhaps Haneke Ackerman. Are there other slow filmmakers whose films you admire and you like and you don't feel angry?
<笑><笑>他非常喜欢这两部，然后他说，他的小女儿有一些电影比较慢的电影，他就提前一些名字，他说有没有喜欢的，而且不给你交流。<笑>有啊，也有的，也有。我很早很早。 我读书的时候就看过一个电影，叫，是一个比利时的电影，一个女导演，啊，是不是
Agnes Varda？
我不知道她的名字，因为我不会翻。她的电影叫《安娜的旅程》，拍一个女人坐火车坐了好久，你上完厕所出来，她还在那边坐火车。There
was a film by this Belgian Belgian woman. She made a film about somebody on a train, a woman on a train, and the film like goes on and on and on, and you can go to the toilet, you can come back, and she's still on the train. Ackerman? Yeah, that's it. Yes. So I saw her film when I was a student, and I really liked it.
是我喜欢很多导演，慢的。
I like a lot of slow directors.
我也喜欢快的导演。
I also like some speedy directors.
都不是问题。It's
not a problem, really.
就是好，要拍得好。It
just is a question of is the film a good film? Is it made well?
我想分享，我最近看一个日本的武侠片，那个《盲剑客》。我重看，我小时候看过，忘了，我在看，我看到那个电影，我很惊讶，它的第一集非常好。 我以为是一个商业，普通的商业片。我小时候看的，我再看，真的非常非常好，已经变成经典了。There
was a film that I saw when I was a little kid about a blind samurai, and so I saw it again recently. I didn't know what to expect. I thought maybe it was just going to be some ordinary commercial. It's a Japanese film, and I saw it again. It was amazing. It was really, really great. I really loved it. Yes, here we have a microphone.
Is it on? Right. This is just a curious question. That as a rebel, that you just define yourself, right? And do you feel comfortable with the identity you were? You were initially experimenting, and then gradually you are also defined by your audience as a person, as a director who produces slow movies. Do you feel comfortable about it?
就是说, the idea of getting a category stuck on you? Or?
Yeah, or an identity. That is, 本来就是你觉得现在你本来是在实验这个慢的东西作为你反叛的一个行为，可是后来逐渐就是你开始就是做了很多慢的电影，然后观众学者也开始写说，哦，你就是做慢电影的人，那你觉得这样舒服吗？就是身为一个反叛的人，对这样的认同。
我没有做实验呢，我从来不做实验的。
It's not really an it's not an experiment for me. I don't experiment as such.
每个作品就是用一种找一种方法来表达。
Each movie finds its own method to express itself.
我舒服的，我非常舒服。
It's about what makes me comfortable.
Thanks for your film. Is stillness just an extreme form of slowness? Is there a difference? Is there a difference? And if so, what space is there for stillness in your films?
You know, as a filmmaker, I don't actually analyze it to that extent. I don't start with like a theory and then make the film, so it's kind of hard to.
后来人家说很多，我说哦，是是是。
After I've made the films, people go, you know, this, and I'm like, oh yeah.
其实我觉得我们不太应该常常讨论慢。
Actually, I don't think.
不应该讨论不动。不应该，不应该，对。不动。不太应该讨老是讨论什么长镜头啦，慢啦。我觉得没什么好讨论的。就好像你不应该常讨论同志一样。你为什么要讨论呢？它是一种方法，一种方式嘛，对不对？
I you know, it's like long shots and slowness. People love to talk about this, but. I don't know, is there really that much to talk about? I just don't know that there is that much to talk about with this slowness. I know. The important thing is, what do you see? So when I do this kind of thing, what do you feel? What have you got from what I'm doing? That's kind of more...
是以前有一个导演，台湾的，公开的说，某个导演我不能说。There
was this film director in Taiwan who once said, "I said which film director?"
我要拍一个电影，每个镜头是3秒钟，来反对蔡明亮的电影。
A director, I can't name him, a Taiwan film director said, "I want to make a film in which every shot." It's 3 seconds long only, and it's a film that I'm making in opposition to Tsai Ming-Lang.
那我就很希望他拍一个每个镜头3秒钟的电影，是一部成功的电影。
I really hope he does it, and I hope it succeeds. Yeah, I hope it's really successful.
不需要反对任何人。我拍电影也不反对好莱坞。我虽然非常讨厌现在好莱坞的电影，可是我不反对它。你们看吧，你知道，你们就看吧，对不对？可是我也要让你们看我的电影啊。I don't.
You know, I don't love a lot of Hollywood, but I don't oppose Hollywood. I'm not saying don't go to see Hollywood films. I just hope you appreciate my films.
Sorry, 我不太知道怎么回答他的问题，但是我说
basically, I just don't know how to answer that question.
很想让你自己想一想，说我这么慢或者我固定镜头，你到底感觉到什么或者看到什么？
So it's more like I'm more interested in the question of. When I have this really slow, you know, scene, or there's stillness, there's a shot that doesn't move, what do you get out of it?
其实现在很多人对每一件事情都有问题，包括为什么你要用李康生用那么久，他们也觉得很奇怪，为什么会奇怪？我不懂。People
are always asking questions that leave me slightly, just kind of like, oh, why did they ask that question? That's really strange. Like people go. Why do you always use Li Kangsheng? You know, and I'm like, well, why? Why do you ask that question? You know.
所以有的时候我们在讨论电影, 很难讨论的原因在，大家用固定的头脑来，来把每个固定的想法来问一个，其实他并没有这样想的一个人来问他问题。
There's often this thing where there are these kind of set ways of thinking or set questions, set, you know, this has been sort of established ways of approaching a question. And, you know, you're asking it of somebody who, who's not set in stone. Yeah. Is that right? Yeah. Is that right?
没关系.
Jiang Xiang, sort of, who isn't himself formed in a kind of a set mold.
对对对，那个潜影。
谢谢啊，就是我先用中文讲啊。对，我有一个问题，就是说，就比较这个两个片子的话，然后第一个片子我感觉就是环境还是很重要，包括就是有那个两个楼梯啊，然后我也看到在河流里面有两个楼梯，就是大家在楼梯上相遇，可能就不相识，然后错过，然后就觉得好像这个空间就是处处有各种随机的事情发生那样子。然后到了第二个片子的话，就是好像这个环境已经不是那么重要，而是这个人他的身体是更加重要。包括我也很有感触，就是在他在走楼梯的时候，我就想啊，原来走路是那么艰难的一件事情，就是你要移动重心，然后在某一个时刻你只有单脚站立，然后实际上很容易摔倒那样，就会想到就是自己这个身体在每天的日常生活当中的这个能动性和它的一种脆弱。对，然后我就想问，就是说那这个环境就是您现在的电影当中，你去日本拍啊，去香港拍啊，然后这个环境对他的这个走路到底还有什么作用？就是 just very briefly, so if you compare the two films, the first film has a lot of focus on the environment, on the spatial environment of Taiwan and the chance encounters in that spatial environment. But in the second film, the environment is missing, and we are focused more on the body and on its movements, and having to change weight and having to stand on one feet, you know, just the act of walking itself. And just wonder, for these walking series, how is the environment going to play in the films if he's going to film in Japan and in Hong Kong?
我先说，李康生是很了不起的，因为这个表演非常。
I first have to say that Li Kangsheng is absolutely astonishing. It is a really, really difficult performance. When he was doing the stairs, you know, and he said to me, he said, you know, you're killing me. I don't think I want to do the Hong Kong one. Of course he did. In Marseille, he had to do an even higher set of stairs.
然后他跟我讲说，这是我走的最好的一次。
哪一个？
马赛呢？
哦，马赛。He himself felt that his performance in the one that was made in Marseille was his best.
Yeah. 然后我在马赛的时候就跟他讲了一件事情，决定了一个做一个决定。我说，小康，以后我说开机，在两分钟内我没有说停，你就不会 NG 你，就不会停，你就可以。走完它，不会拍第二次，因为第二
如果两分钟没有的话就没有
对如果两分钟没有觉得不对的话，你可以继续走完了，因为每次都要走20分钟到半小时，每一个镜头，所以我说我不会再喊停，
What I said to
只会走一次，
What I said to him is because the Walker films are all about 20 or 30 minutes or so, and they are one take.So what I said to him is if in the first 2 minutes of shooting, if I don't call out cut, then keep going and I will let you continue and that will be the take.
Yeah,
so if I don't stop it in the first 2 minutes, then it's the take. Because I don't want you to be that, you know, to be that hard for you.
我觉得这个走路的电影让我学习了接受更多的, 接受更多, 几乎可以, 什么都接受了, 接受更多。
What I learned in the process of making, or what I have learned, am learning in the process of these making these films, is to accept, to be more accepting, to be able to accept whatever happens.
Yeah, so, 我真不知道要拍什么，我不知道，我也不想知道。
So, you know, every different environment suggests a different speed. I don't actually know, I don't have a preconceived idea when I go into that environment of what I'm going to actually be shooting.
我就想看会发生什么。
My attitude is I want to look at and see what happens.
因为那个时间的长度足够让我们看到, 看到一个状态。
Because the time that I'll give,
管发生什么事,
the time that I'll give the shot is time enough for something to happen, for a situation to develop, and I want to observe that.
Yeah, 当然我还是要去选景.
But of course, I do want to pick the places, so I.
对，景很重要.
The place, the environment, the scene is very, very important. Yeah,
像我这次去日本, 我就不会去选, 大家去的地方。 我去香港我也不选，因为我觉得我不是要拍一个观光片，啊，我只选一个我有感觉的地方。I'm,
you know, when I go to Japan, I probably not be setting my film in places that are very familiar to people because I'm not making a travelogue. I'm looking for something that gives me inspiration.
其实我觉得创作到后来，就是一个不知道。 往不知道那边走过去，但是你要有一个方向，方向是非常清楚的，但是不知道是什么。你看玄奘去印度那个过程，他知道他能够走到印度吗？他不知道，他会遇到什么国家？他不知道，遇到什么人？他不知道。So
the thing is, you've got this direction, like Xuanzang the monk. His goal was to get to India and get the sutras and bring them back to China, but what was he going to encounter on that road? Who was he going to meet? What was going to happen? He couldn't know. And that's the sense that I'm bringing to this.
如果我的前面是一堆钱的话，我就知道怎么做。懂我的意思吗？我的电影不是，真的不是，已经不没有那个思考了。所以我反而非常自由，我也非常享受。
You know, it would be kind of different if there was this like big pile of cash over there. But, you know, I really, it is a sense of discovery along the way. Are there any more burning questions? Because, okay, so we've got two more questions. We'll start with you, and then we'll come to you.
大家都不想回家了。
Nobody wants to go home.
Hi, I know when you were a child, you watched a lot of movies with your grandparents, and I wanted to know, like obviously that had a big influence on your filmmaking, especially in Busan, Goodbye Dragon Inn, and I wanted to, I guess, yeah, hear about what that experience was like for you and how big an influence that was on your filmmaking.
It was really an important thing for me. And it was, you know, it was the will of the heavens. It was, that was my fate to see these films. To just explain, every single day, Tsai Ming-Lang went with either his grandmother or his grandpa to see a film when he was little.
我觉得每一个过程都重要，因为我的电影都是一种自我的表达。
But everything every process, everything I've been through is also important because my films are self-expression. So I'm expressing myself and what I've
been through. Yeah, so, 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 老戏院就非常特别。我其实那些老戏院，我想澳洲人都知道。 在60、70年代，全世界都有这种大的戏院。我们经历过之后，知道那种甜蜜甜美，太好了。可是它有一天不见了，很快不见了。其实你也不会去记得它，因为你知道世界就是这样往前走嘛。很多新的看电影还是有电影看啊。可是有一天你会梦到它，而且常常梦到它。你没有想它，你会梦它，表示你老了。
When I was little, the films, the cinemas that we went to, everybody here of a certain age and Australians would all know that in the 60s and 70s, the cinemas that were around were really, really special. Very, very special places, and they were, you know, they were lovely. And so seeing films there were, it was quite a special experience. It was the actual cinema as well, you know, was fantastic. And so now maybe it's just a sign of getting older. I often dream of those beautiful old cinemas from that time. And 梦到他. Yeah, you're not even thinking of that's right. And so you're not even like trying to think of them, and they just come into your dreams, they come into your thoughts, and it's like those old cinemas are telling me, there's something I want you to do. I want to push you along on something. So just live well, really. It's important. Now we'll have one final question. Oh, we have two questions, do we? Okay. Okay. 最后两个问题. Okay. Sorry, you'll be the last.
Okay. 蔡老师你好。蔡老师你好。我们是同宗。我们还有另外同一点的地方。据我所知，你出生于马来西亚，我也是出生于马来西亚。
This gentleman is also a Mr. Tsai who was born in Malaysia.
刚才看了你那位主角在走路的时候，我就想起了阴阳之道。我们走路，每一个人都要符合阴阳之道，就是有时也有虚，虚时不化。 这样子才能够保持我们身体的平衡，这样子我们才能够向前走，朝前方走去，不会跌倒。我不知道你在做那片子的时候，有没有想到这阴阳之道，在他漫步走路的时候能够表现出来。
This is a very philosophical question, and that is that there's a concept of the path of yin and yang, and there's absence and presence, and every step is a dance of absence and presence, and I'm hoping I'm getting this right, and so this absence and presence, we realize ourselves through this path of yin and yang. How much, if at all, did that play into your mind when you were doing this film?
没有想到。
Not at all. I wasn't thinking of that.
但是很好玩是，很多学气功的人来看到这个电影，都觉得李康生，好像在，或者行禅那种，那些师傅行禅，他们看到这个电影都觉得，非常接近那个呼吸的。 协调都非常的靠近，所以李康生是一个，他因为要演这个电影，他自己就，怎么讲？我觉得这是人的自然，找到一个他自己的自然，所以我这是非常期待说有一天，大家有时候可以怎么讲呢？就是说，比如说李康生来了，要到哪里拍这个片子，你遇到我们的时候，你也可以一起来走。 你知道，我有这个想法，但是可遇不可期，我也不会宣布大家来走，但我觉得这个只是一个，我觉得像一个修行，好，这个电影我跟李康生都有很强烈的感觉到，我们也在做我们的修行，大概是这样。
I feel that this is it's kind of a spiritual practice, even though you know I wasn't thinking of this yin yang thing. But when various people have seen the film or the films, especially say qigong people who whose practice also refers to yin yang, dao and this you know and the I Ching and all of this sort of thing, they recognize a commonality in. In this practice, they also think that Li Kangsheng is quite. He's got that sort of. He's got the qi. He's got that. He's got that the natural. What the Taoists talk about is nature. So he has that thing. And so yes, in a sense, even though I wasn't intending that, that's where in a way it has ended up.
最后一个问题，老师，导演，谢谢。就是我的问题就是，其实刚才你有回答一个问题，说，那重点在于我们看到了什么。那我很好奇，就是说，当你自己在拍完的时候，在拍的时候，还有在你之后再看的时候，就是每次时间，就是那时间一定是不一样。然后你是不是看到的东西也不一样？有没有特别？ 有一两次你觉得比较不一样的经验，就觉得看到的东西比较特别的印象，对。然后因为就我自己，我觉得我刚才就是看到了，就是虽然在走路，感觉就是像你说，就是它前面好像有一个东西，但是换到下一幕，其实发现它还是继续在走，然后那场景已经不一样，可是感觉就是每次好像都有一个镜头，可是。 走到那里时候，其实又下一个，然后到最后一幕，我觉得那个就是感觉就是那个镜头是，其实也不是镜头，本来以为我们在看，我原本以为是我在看这部电影，到最后感觉好像是我自己的感觉是李汉生在看我们，对，所以。那。
Give a short summary.
The director answered a question and previously and his answer was that you know the point is that you know what the audience can see from the movie. So my question is that you know when he was filmed the film and then he will probably watch it later. Then so if he can see something different from his movie, yeah, something like that.
我现在发现现在的气氛非常好，虽然要结束了，气氛非常好，大家非常有耐心。I
think everybody is amazing here. It's such a nice atmosphere. Everybody's so patient.
就是因为看了我的电影。And
that's because you've all seen my films.
是，没有耐心可能就走了。And
if you know, if there was no patience, you'd be gone.
可能有一些人开始没什么耐心，慢慢就有耐心。
And some people, you know, they start out patient and, they start out impatient and then they slowly grow patience.
这个影，我的这些大部分的电影，我其实没有语言，特别走到这种状态，更没有语言。
I don't have a lot of words. I don't have a lot of dialogue in my films.
Yeah, 我想说，大家就是用眼睛在看，真的回归到看电影的概念，就看电影嘛，看电影。
So it's you say I'm watching a film and with my films you really are watching, you're watching. That's what you're doing. That's how you take them in.
我觉得很重要这个看的概念，但是我们逐渐失去了看的耐心。
I think, you know, watching is really an important concept, and that we're losing that patience for watching.
如果你认真说, 我宁愿看天, 大自然, 我觉得比看一个电影好看, 比看我的电影好看。
If you, you know, actually look at nature, at the natural world, it's a lot better than watching my films. I mean, a lot more beautiful.
可是如果你心没有办法静下来, 你不会看大自然,
but you have to have that patience, you have to have that stillness and that calmness to be able to look at nature.
你知道我这次来澳洲, 我往窗外看啊, 我觉得最不一样是你们的云跟我们不一样。 天上的云, 其实是不一样的。
I, you know, I look out my window here. I've come to Australia. I look out my window, and I'm looking at the clouds, and I think, wow, they're really different from our clouds.
特别立体, 不知道为什么。
They're really three-dimensional. They're really, yeah, three-dimensional.
所以我就一直看那个云。我觉得来这边我也一直看树。
I've also been looking at the trees.
Yeah, 我喜欢看树。
Oh, God, shoo?
Shoo, tree.
Yeah, trees, okay. Because I know you've been reading a lot here, so I was
just
not
sure. Yeah.
Sorry, for those of you who don't speak Chinese, shoo is books and shoo is tree. Yeah. So I know that he's been reading a lot, so I just wanted to make sure. Yes, yeah. He's been looking at the trees too.
对,每一棵树都很美。
And every tree is just incredibly beautiful.
后来你觉得每一个人都很美。
And then you think every person is very beautiful.
Yeah, 我觉得是这样子，就不会去整形了，不要整形了，不要去美容，做脸了。Yeah,
there's no reason to do anything. Everybody is beautiful.
我在台湾常做演讲，有很多有钱的太太来听我演讲，听完他们就很有自信，就觉得不要去整形了。
You know, sometimes I give these talks in Taiwan, and all these like rich ladies come, and when I finished, they don't feel like they go and have to have plastic surgery and all that sort of thing.
我那天不知道，我觉得有时候语言当然还是很重要，他要有一点沟通，沟通完他就对我的电影有一点好感，然后他就愿意，所以我说，你知道我讲一个事情，我来之前我一个朋友，他做生意的，他说蔡明亮，我一个女士。 我去年亏了1000多万，怎么办？什么什么？我说，我有个方法，一定会让你赚回来。So
I have this friend. She's a businesswoman, and she says to me, "I've lost 1000万，1000万，10 million. Is that right? Yeah, 10 million. It's presumably Taiwan dollars. And he said, "I know how you can get that back."
你去读，你去抄《金刚经》3个月。 抄那个Diamond Sutra.
Oh, right.
我叫他去抄，每天晚上抄《心刚经》，抄3个月，你的钱就会回来了。
So I said to her, every night for 3 months, you are to copy out the Diamond Sutra, a Buddhist text, and your money will come back.
她说真的吗？
And she said, really?
我说真的。And
I said, really?
去抄吧。And
I said, go do it.
不知道会发生什么。I
have no idea what might happen.
对，没有，你懂我的意思。我觉得说一定会有改变的。But
something will happen.
不一定，一定会改变，但是什么我不知道。Yeah,
there'll be some sort of change, but what it is, who knows?
Yeah,
and that's kind of an interesting note.
这是一种方法，一种方法，很好。 你问我什么？其实我忘了。But
you know, actually, what you asked me, I've forgotten.
简单说，我不太回来看我的作品。好，但是我很开心别人看我的作品，哪怕他觉得受苦。I
don't really come back and watch my films over and over again, but I'm glad that other people do. And
像每次放我的电影，我知道很慢，我就在外面散步，然后想象他们。 在里面看几分钟，几分钟的过去，我会这样想象。有时候我会吃很好吃的东西，我想他们在看李康生跟陈湘琪站在那边14分钟，他们是什么感受？当然我不会去问他们，我觉得每一个人都不一样，没有关系。
I when my films are showing, I go out and I walk around and sometimes I get something to eat, and but I think all the time, like I think about you, and I think, oh, gee, I wonder, right now I'm eating something really yummy, and they're watching that shot that took 14 minutes, and the two characters are just standing there, and you know, I'm kind of curious, but I'm not going to ask.
我不想问人家的感觉，像我的演员脱光了，演得很辛苦，我从来不会慰问他，我只是抱他一下，结束，他自己去消化。你懂我意思吗？那些都说太多也没有用，你什么感觉不重要，你演到我要的就好了。之后我就是，如果他脱光，我通常都抱他，不是要去卡油，就是要去抱他，感谢他。
So, you know, my actors, they basically, you know, they strip naked, they're just, and I don't say to them, you know, I don't ask them how they're feeling, I don't do this, I just, you know, I appreciate it. And I'll give them a hug at the end.
所以你知道我曾经在法国拍那个脸嘛，那个电影，我的女演员是一个名模。 哦，他们平常就脱光的，换衣服什么都很不care。我跟他见面的时候，我说我希望那场戏你什么都不要穿。他就跟我讲一句话，他说所有的导演都要我脱光。可是呢，他就说了一句话，我说我不只是要你脱光，我要你自己想象自己是一块肉，挂在那边在贩卖。他就。 他没有什么反应，他就走了。后来他来到我的现场，二话不说，什么都可以。后来他就接受一个访问，他说：“所有的男人，导演都会要我脱衣服，可是我还没有脱之前，我已经被脱光了。但是只有一个人没有让我有这种感觉，就是蔡明亮。”When
I was making Face, which is a film for the Louvre. One of the actors in it is a famous model, and I said to her, you're going to have to take off all your clothes, and what I want you to do is think of yourself as a slab of meat just hanging there. And she kind of went, right, and just walked away. And then she shows up for the filming, and she just takes off her clothes and, you know, does it. And then later she was saying to a reporter, you know, all male directors, they just go, yeah, you've got to take off your clothes. But I always know that even before I take off my clothes, they've stripped me naked. There's only one male director that doesn't give me that feeling, and that's Tsai Ming-Lang.
Thank you.
谢谢你们. Thank you.